Okay, this is part two of my LK8000 review of IGC flight that I took at the Region 5 contest in 2017. I've already set up the task and you can see it on the screen. And now I'm going to review the flight that I flew and show you, how LK8000 responds during the flight. But first, I wanted to make a slight correction to my configuration. I have this set up with all the turn points, but I realized that the minimum time should be 2 hours and 30 minutes, and the minimum finish altitude is 1300 feet MSL, and the task max start altitude is 5000. So I don't have LK8000 set up correctly, so I'm going to show you how to do that. All right, so you need to go down here and go back to navigation, navigation screen 2, edit the task, and you can go through and you want to double click the very first waypoint, and then you can go back and look at these screens. So this cylinder or start type is correct, the radius is correct, AAT is on. The minimum time was, instead of 120 minutes, it should be 150 minutes. So you can easily edit that by doing this. And it's going to auto advance. And then you want to go back to task rules. And the maximum start height should be 5,000 feet MSL. So I'm going to change that to 5,000. And this is important. You want to make sure that these reference height references MSL based on what the task sheet says. In this case, again, it's MSL right here. And the minimum finish is 1300 feet. So you want to program that in there. So that if I had it at 1000, my final glide would get me under the 1300 feet and be a penalty. Okay, so that's it, done. And I'm going to close this. So everything should be fine now. And I'm going to save this again. And you have you can't bring up the file, so you need to just rename it and call it Perry Day Region 5 Practice Day 2. Oops. It should say that there's something already, and I'm just going to overwrite that. All right, so now it's 150 minutes, 136 miles. All right, so now I'm ready to go, so I'm going to close this, and I'm going to load up my file, and to do that, you go here to Configuration, Screen 2, Logger Replay, and then you'll find the file, and I believe it's this one right here. So, select that, and you can change the rate, and I will do that to truncate this video, but to play it back, you just hit Start, and now it's going to run. And using the keyboard, you'll see down in the corner be 1x, 2x, 3x. That you can, it will tell you how fast I'm playing this back. And so we'll do that to try to shorten the amount of time this video takes. So I'm just going to advance this, and you can see that I'm just sitting on the grid waiting to launch. So now I'm going to use my keyboard. And you can see the numbers down in the corner change right here. So I'm going to speed this up. And get back to you when I have launched and I'm going to start the race. All right, so I've advanced this a little bit because there was a little bit of a delay from when I turned on the recorder. But you can see that LK automatically senses me flying, and the lift is in red, the sync is in blue, so it does a good job of telling you where the thermals are located, so it marks that with a circle. And so right now I'm just trying to climb. You can see that it gives me at the bottom the information regarding the thermal strength for the last 30 seconds, the thermal average climb value, how much time I've spent climbing, the altitude gain in the thermal that I'm in, what the altitude I'm at. And it's telling me that I've just violated the start rules because I went over the 5,000 feet. So, you know, these are things you need to know about the different fields that are on the screen. This right here is efficiency, and it will give you information about the winds, but you can see when you're reviewing your flights how well you're doing as far as sync, standard, and thermals. The little double click or double bells that you just heard were indication that I need to wait 1 to 2 seconds, fly straight right when you hear that, and then begin turning again. So it's telling me that I'm not quite staying centered, and there's, you know, the wind's not indicated on here yet, but it will help you, guide you. It's telling me to fly straight there for 2 seconds and then turn. So I delayed 2 seconds, and this is played back at twice the speed. So it helps you, guide you to stay in the thermal, in the strongest part of the thermal. All right, so I'm still climbing. Remember, 5,600 feet, I'm 600 feet above where I need to be for the start. If you look at the feel, I'm backing out. I'm outside the start cylinder, and so I need to get inside this circle right here because I'm going to be heading south with this green line. So the purple line is telling me that's the direction I need to head to get to the next waypoint. And the waypoint, again, is start cylinder 4. It's telling me the direction I need to fly, how far away I am from that, and that sort of information. This is the thermal band right here in the upper left. It tells me the profile of the thermal that I'm flying in. And that's important to recognize that because the strength of the thermal, if it's really wide like this at the bottom at a low altitude, that means you can catch a thermal if they're going to stay the same strength, but you'll be able to catch a thermal at a low altitude, and the thermal should be relatively strong. So you get a chance to see what the thermal profile looks like. So this is very important. The little black triangle just indicates your altitude. So LK8000 updates this thermal band throughout your flight. Again, 5,000 feet is the maximum that I'm supposed to be at, so I violated the start rule. So it guides you and lets you know that you need to get a little bit lower. These green symbols indicate areas that you can reach based on your altitude. And so you can see that I can fly a long way. And the red and white line and the green line are guides to help let you know how far you can get. This is a safety altitude, and the green line is your maximum distance that you can fly based on the polar of the glider. And so I can reach quite a long way just with the altitude that I have at that. But again, I need to get into the start cylinder, and then I'm going to head in this direction to start the race. So but it provides a lot of really valuable information. So I have a nice climb, and I'm heading into the start cylinder. And you can see that my altitude down here is 5,200 feet. So I'm still above the start altitude. And but that's no problem because I have a long way to go. It's guiding me. This purple line is guiding me to the middle of that that area. And this black line here is the direction that my glider is actually flying. So I'm going to fast forward this a little bit so we can get close to the start of the race. All right, so I've now advanced this so that I've started the race. It's going to lead me to the next turn point, which is Barnwell. And so it's leaving breadcrumbs. You can see that my speed here is 53 knots. I'm sinking, so I'm not really flying into thermals at all. It's telling me that I have 2,700 feet be able to reach, 2,700 feet above where I need to be able to get to Barnwell. And in this particular race, it was a practice day, so I didn't go deep into the cylinder. But as soon as I the green arrow or the green cylinder is nicked, and you can see where it's going to do that here in just a moment, then I know I've reached there. So it's telling me, okay, I can now go to the next turn point, and it gives me guidance here, you know, exactly where I need to go to be able to get to that next turn point. I'm at 5,200 feet. Found a nice thermal right here, so it's marked this, the thermal. I'm playing this back at 6x, so slow it down a little bit. It's a little jagged, but this is the way it would really look while I'm flying. Distance is 28 miles to the next center of the next turn point. And to be able to reach that, I'm 2,500 feet above where I need to be able to get to that turn point. So I know that if I'd left this thermal now, I'd have plenty of altitude to be able to get all the way to that turn point. I spent 28% of my time climbing. So you want to try to minimize the percent of time that you're climbing. So, you know, being a practice round, I wasn't really working on trying to be that have the fastest. I just wanted to get familiar with the area since I've never flown that area before. I'm almost at 6,000 feet. You can see the thermal band up here in the upper left corner, what it looks like, the profile. And so I know that there's some really good, if I stay high, there's lots of strong lift. So it tells me the direction of the wind is 118, and it's at 1 mile per hour or 1 knot. And it tells me down in the bottom right, the task speed average tells me the time that I'm going to arrive at the turn point. So I'm spending a lot of time climbing, thermal gain is a lot. So again, I'm not trying to go fast. I'm just trying to, learn the area and, determine the strength of the thermals. I really like this thermal that I was in, so it marked it right here for me. So this is what this means, and the blue arrow saying, okay, turn, this is the direction you need to go. It doesn't, I'd like to be able to optimize my points by flying to the rear of this turn point cylinder. The LK8000 doesn't do a very good job of optimizing, leading me to that. So it draws this line, but it doesn't go to the back, and I'd like it to do that. But it draws the line to the center of it. So if I wanted to continue to the center, it's telling me to go to the, take a left turn and go to the next turn point. But if I wanted to fly to the center of this turn point, I could follow this dashed line. So I'm going to advance it. So it's going to be a little jagged, but decided that I don't want to go any further. And so it's telling me I have 1,500 feet to be able to make it to the next turn point, to the middle of the next turn point. And so I'm heading off that direction and 23 miles away. Gives me information, and what you can do is you can, while you're flying, you can look at this screen in different ways. You can back off, you can zoom in, you can click here, and it gives you more information about your cruise, gives you distances to different turn points, and tells me my alternate arrival altitude. So I can't make it to Allen's or Earhart. Now I can, but a moment ago I couldn't. But it gives me the altitudes to be able to fly directly to that location. And you can click through here like that. It gives me a best alternate if I wanted to abandon my flight and fly back to a safe landing site. And then this is also gives me some information about the arrival altitude if I left where I'm at and going flying directly to these waypoints. So I could easily make it back to the finish line. 2,500 feet from where I'm at, it's only 7 miles away. So, and you'll have to learn more about the navigation by clicking through here. Okay, so I sped this up quite a bit. So I've already hit the next turn point. I just nicked it. You can see it right down here. And now I'm heading to the next turn point, which is House Movers. So again, these green markers indicate areas that I could fly to. The red means I could not reach it safely without climbing. And so you'll see this, you know, in the red line, the dash red and white lines indicate areas that I could reach. So I'm at 3,000. I'm 3,800 feet above where I need to be able to reach the 16 miles to the next waypoint, House Movers. And again, I'm gonna slow this down. You can see I'm at 14x, so I'll slow it down a little bit so you can kind of feel, get a feel for what it's going to look like in true speed. So that's the true speed right there. So green line tells me the direction I need to go to the turn point. Now the green line was the line that was going to give me the maximum with the shortest distance. And if I wanted to fly that more efficiently, that would be, you know, flying instead of zigzagging back and forth is going to slow my time down, so you want to fly a direct route. So the trail, you can breadcrumbs, you can see this. You know, based on the thermal band, telling me that I'm still above the thermal band. So if I find some thermals, I can find some good climb. Another thing I can do is I can look here, and it gives me some speed to fly information. The auto MacCready is 0.1, which is up in here. That's what this E means. It's an efficiency, their keyword for MacCready. Home distance 10 miles away gives me some information about the altitudes that I arrive at in the next ETA. Test speed is 51. Climbing is 16%, so I'm doing better. And how much I've gained in the last thermal climb, rate of climb in the last 30 seconds, and the average for my entire flight is thermal all. So this arrow here is wind speed, and it's telling me it's at 10 knots now. So it's really at 6,400 feet. It's really, you know, much different than it was at 4,000 feet. It tells me the direction, so I can use that information to help, you know, help me make some decisions. Now it's coming out of the north at about 5 knots, so I don't know why it automatically flipped, but it's already done the calculations for me. So I'm less than 10 miles away from House Movers, and I have so much altitude, 4,700 feet, but I'm enjoying the flight so much that I just didn't really care about the speed at this point. I just wanted to enjoy climbing and, you know, kind of a relaxed atmosphere since it wasn't a contest day. I'm going to speed this up again. So you can see in the bottom right, the speed is going to be a little jagged because I've sped it up, but it's marked again, that little T green arrow, that's telling me that it's found another nice thermal to mark it for me. I can go back to those thermals later on, and hopefully I can find that thermal. I've done that in the past in blue conditions where I've marked a really nice thermal and got low at one point. And then realized, okay, I'm going to try that thermal that I had just marked 20 minutes earlier. I flew back to that spot, and I found a beautiful thermal, strong thermal, in that same spot just by following the breadcrumbs back to the thermal. So now I'm just taking a little shortcut here so I can speed this up. I'm just going to nick this cylinder. And again, I'm giving me information about 5.6, and some of those is redundant, but House Movers, let me go down so you can see, it's marked another really nice thermal right here. The wind is 5 knots out of 008, and we're at 5,500 feet. And you can configure your entire screen, so you can put as much information on the screen as you want. You can take most of it off. Now, the other thing that I haven't shown you, there's some of the other options, and there's screen 4, And three, and it gives you information about airspace, whether you're going to come close to airspace. But this is some information about house movers and how far you're above reaching your goal. So it's a little bit different book. And this is a final glide calculation. I mean, I have enough altitude to go over 30 miles. So that's what that's all about. So I didn't nick the cylinder, but that little double ding means hold straight for 2 seconds and then turn. So that's why why I did that. And I'm not flying very well right there, but I think the lift was so strong, I didn't really need to turn or bank too steeply. So, all right, so it's just nicked the next cylinder. And now the purple line is telling me to go to the next cylinder. Again, to maximize your point, you want to go further back into the cylinder. And so you will have to be very careful about, make calculating where you want to go in the cylinder. But it's just, I can't find a way to configure LK8000 so that I can actually indicate that the optimal distance would be way back here in the corner. And so if I went back that far and then to the next turn point, I can maximize my points. So you have to fly with this and just take that into consideration, that these lines are telling you, providing information and guidance as far as where you need to go to be able to get to the next waypoint rather than maximize your points. So I've climbed quite a bit. I'm at 5,500 feet. And now I'm going to speed this up a little bit and fly towards Aiken, which is 14 miles away. You can see my thermal band. I've flown that little black bar where I'm at in the thermal band. The profile has changed a little bit. So here's the distance to Aiken. It's redundant. It's at the top here. It's way down here. So this is info boxes, and you can configure these. And I'll just scroll through them so you can see different things. It's telling me speed to fly, that sort of thing. You can have that speed to fly show up in different areas. Test speed, that sort of thing. Home distance, home arrival altitude. This red line means I don't have enough altitude to get back to the finish cylinder. Telling me that I would need some altitude, additional altitude. You'll see that change in just a minute. 14.3 miles to Aiken, the waypoint. I think 9.9 is, not sure what the difference is, but the home arrival is right here. It's telling me that finished. Now it's going to tell me that I'm above final glide and I'm 909 feet or 900 feet above final glide to be 1,000 feet above the ground. That was a safety. So initially it's, I think, be 2,000 feet above. Thermal profile again. And I'm just climbing because as of being 15 miles away, I wanted to make sure that I had an enjoyable flight. So I'm 5,700 feet above the ground, so I have plenty of altitude. So in this case, I ended up just screaming back to burn up all this altitude. 2,400 feet above final glide. I have so much altitude. Just my speed, you'll be able to see the speed come up. I think as I got closer and closer, I was just really screaming. 11 miles away. Let's see what it does here. So, 66 knots. This wasn't the flight that where I was doing 130 knots. It was another day where I had so much altitude. Wasn't flying the best, but it was my one of the first contests that I've ever done, and so I had a lot to learn. But this is the finish, and it will flash, make you call when you're 4 miles out, make you call, and then you next finish, and it tells you that you finished. So this gives you the information. 44.3 is the task speed. So that's LK8000 flying the task, and gives you like an 800 feet configuration to check your gear. And I'm gonna slow this down, and you can see that I've landed. So give me the information. Now if I go back to the screen and look at the task, and I look at the analysis, you can see what I did, and that's the red. So I didn't do a very good job of going deep into the cylinders. So, and I was way short, I think, of task time. So this is the track that I took. And the distance gives me, if you're doing LLC, it gives you that information. This is the altitudes that I was flying at. And this is my analysis of my climb, strength, and speed. So at one point I was flying very slow, then I sped up, and then I was and analysis of the wind. So, all right. Well, that's all I have. If you have any comments, please leave them down below. I'd really love to hear from you. Let me know what you think. Perhaps how I can configure LK8000 a little differently. And, you know, it's something I just started using a few years ago, and I really enjoy it, and will continue to use it. But, you know, I may need to reconfigure it a little bit so that I can be a better flight contest a little more efficiently. So, all right, thank you.